If a civilization can ensure spiritual seeking, if civilization can give you assurance, be a spiritual seeker, you will not lose anything. Our civilization, society setup is created in that way. In India they tried. In India they tried. And the experiment was really successful. The experiment was really successful. If you are a seeker, you will never lose anything in that society. Anything in that society. In my case, I lived cream of my life. Cream of my life is youth. Between 17 to 25, I neither studied nor worked for a society. If I was in any other country, I would have been put in the homeless asylum. Homeless shelter. Or mad people asylum. They would have put me in all psychotherapy, psychiatry, psychopathy, all kinds of pathies and therapies and deprogramming programs. They would have put all possible medicines and doses on me. But the great civilization, the great society did not do that to me. When I was on my own, when I started seeking, it had sympathy, it had passions, it had compassion. Apart from that, it gave me food, shelter, clothes, everything with respect. Understand? Not saying you are an unwanted guy, but we have to maintain what to do. No. Not with that feeling. How the homeless people are served. The developed countries, how the homeless people are treated. They will give you food. You are unwanted guy, what to do? We'll give you what you need. At least don't become a criminal. We'll give you what you need. Just keep quiet. Not with that unwanted feeling. No. It's encouraging. Please do it. You are right. You are right. Anywhere, if I'm given food without they touching my feet, I'm not supposed to accept. And that is the way I lived. Understand? You can't imagine giving food to a homeless guy and touching his feet with respect. Can you imagine? No! You can't imagine. In the developed countries, you will give food and shelter and clothes and whatever needed to a homeless guy and fall at his feet and do namaskar. Offer your respect. Saying you are right, please, you are encouraged, please do what you are doing. No! But the civilization did it. The society did it. When I go around all over the world, I understand. I am surprised. The civilization was built for enlightenment. It is built to create enlightened beings. Many times people ask me, why only in India so many enlightened masters are there? Why they are not spread all over the world? They should have been spread. God should have sent here and there. Why they are all completely concentrated in India? Please understand, it is not an accident. It is an incident. The civilization itself is prepared, trained, created for enlightened masters. Same way, there are many things missing. They don't have an Ainonon, as I told you yesterday. They don't have many things which developed countries have. But they have few things which no other civilization can produce. The insurance for seekers. The whole society is an insurance for seekers. Whole civilization is insurance for seekers. Billions and billions of rupees are spent in creating infrastructures, basic needs for the seekers who wander all over the country. Billions of dollars is spent by philanthropists. The first philanthropy activity in India is not creating education infrastructure or medical infrastructure. Infrastructure for seekers. That is the first priority. In India, any rich man, see in the developed countries, any rich man, if he is fed up with the money, if he wants to do charity, only when he feds up with the money, he will do charity. When he feds up with the money, and he wants to do charity, the developed countries, he may create an hospital, or he may create a school, But in India, if he is fed up with the money, and if he wants to do charity, first thing will be, he will create a monastery or a temple. Means infrastructure for seekers. The whole civilization is directed towards enlightenment, towards seeking. So only if you give assurance and respect for seeking, only the civilization which gives assurance and respect for seeking can be liberated from alcohol. If any civilization needs liberation from addiction of alcohol, if it wants to save its citizens from alcohol, the one and only way is encourage seeking. Encourage right knowledge. Lead people towards enlightenment. Lead them towards the conscious growth. Lead them towards super consciousness. That is the one and only way to liberate from alcohol. Till then, alcohol will continue to rule. The addictions will continue to be there. The drugs, the products, which gives the kind of the illusory feeling, will continue to exist either directly or indirectly, legally or illegally, in the society or under the undercover. It will continue to exist because man cannot live without right knowledge or wrong knowledge. Right knowledge always leads to seeking. If that is not encouraged, that is not accepted in the society, if that is not the right track which he can take up, if he is not respected, taken care, if he takes up the right knowledge, naturally what he will do? He has no other option. He has to take the wrong knowledge. He has to take the other side. So any civilization wants to save its citizens, its people, from the addiction or products which creates delusions and illusions, the one and only way is encourage right knowledge. Let that civilization think about encouraging seeking. Let that civilization think about supporting the seeking. In India, I have seen every 30 mile you will have a place for resting and food if you are a seeker. Because I walked length and breadth of India. Maximum I can walk only 30 miles per day. So at rest, I have always found a temple or a monastery where I can rest. I am respected, supported, just because I am a seeker. No other qualification. No ID card is required. In India, there is no social security number. Please understand. But first of all, there is no security. What about social security number? There is no social security number. There is no way to track. There is no way to find out information about you. Nothing exists. The only social security number is this color dress. That's all. You will be surprised. Even in the train, government trains, the government officials who are supposed to take care of whether TTs, ticket checkers, will not ask for a ticket if you are wearing this cloth. Now I am telling you from my experience. If you are with this cloth and sitting, I have never seen any TT asking me ticket. They will ask only one thing: Baba, have you eaten? Means it's a very respectful word. Baba means father. Oh, father, have you taken food? That's all. I wandered 9 years. 9 years I did yatra, means pilgrimage. So, whole length and breadth of India. Every 30 miles, you have a stoppage. You have food with respect. That is the main thing. With respect. They touch your feet. That's the first thing. They touch your feet and offer. And they encourage what you are doing. They support what you are doing. They respect what you are doing. So only a civilization which can support seeking, which can encourage seekers, this is one aspect of seeking I am saying. Even otherwise, even when you are living with your family, if the society knows you are a seeker, you have a different position. You have a different place. You have a different respect. That whole society, it is in their blood. So any civilization encourages seeking, supports seekers, will liberate itself from the wrong knowledge and the products which creates delusion. The products which creates delusion. In India, so much of population, I don't see so much of entertainment. Only recently, last 50 years only, so much of entertainment ideas are gathered. Otherwise, there is no theme park, there was no TV, there was no movie. There was nothing much of entertainment. Even their entertainment is connected to seeking, temple. That is their entertainment. Sometime, I have seen, especially in the West, people are surprised that in India, people go to temples every day. Because in many countries, they go to church only once in a week. It's a Sunday holiday religion. And that also rarely. Not everybody. When I say people go to the temple regularly, every day, people are surprised. But that becomes their lifestyle. Not so much of entertainment. Even entertainment is this only. Prayer is entertainment. This is game. Everything. Everything is rooted at seeking. Based at the search for enlightenment. So civilization which encourages right knowledge helps their citizens to go beyond wrong knowledge, to go beyond addictions. Right knowledge, wrong knowledge, the third pattern, third mental structure, third chitta vritti is imagination. This is another one big problem. This imagination can lead you to right knowledge or wrong knowledge. This can lead you to suffering or joy. If the imagination is used properly, rightly, it can lead you to ecstasy, joy, spiritual ecstasy. It can lead you to ultimate. You will be in the heaven. You can see in your own life how you imagine about yourself plays a major role in your decisions. I've seen sometime when I work with the people, the moment they get an imagination, strong imagination, no, I cannot continue this for whole life, they are gone. How much I tell them, no, it is your imagination, just relax. Once you had an imagination, you can be with me forever, that is the heaven. Now you are having other imagination, you can't stay around me, you can't bear, you can't be. This one more imagination, understand. Use your imagination rightly. They say, no. They think I am using all words to inspire them. Imagination, when it is used wrongly, when it is misunderstood or misused, is the worst thing. It can do worst thing to you. That is the worst thing can happen to you. Imagination, when it is used rightly, can straight away lead you to right knowledge, can straight away liberate you. We have seen about the different modifications, right knowledge, wrong knowledge, imagination, sleep and memory. We understood deeply about right knowledge and wrong knowledge. Imagination, sleep and memory, these three are connected, closely connected. We'll explore, understand what is imagination, what is sleep, what is memory, how they are interconnected, How they can lead us to right knowledge or wrong knowledge, suffering or joy. How they can lead us and how it can be used, we will see. So, with these great truths of Patanjali, let you all experience living enlightenment. Let you all achieve and radiate the eternal bliss, Nityananda.